illuminated sign at the side of the road that says 15 miles to the...
Center, bell time 7:30, 5820 Metro Drive here in Evansville, Indiana. We got a great card lined up. We've got also bring in the canned goods for the canned food drive for Hope Central. Remember, if you bring in at least two canned foods, you get a ticket for a drawing for all kinds of cool merchandise, all kinds of FW merchandise, all kinds of Rob Conway merchandise. Rob's giving us a bunch of stuff, and he's the man. I'll tell you what, thank you, Rob. We love you. God bless you, brother. Flash Flanagan's giving some stuff. Won't you give something?
I am. I'm giving you a picture.
Oh, and oh, he give. He's Team Johnny picture, right?
Yeah. You know who else is giving something?
What's that?
My good buddy Doug Gilbert. Give me a t-shirt.
Doug Gilbert's going to give something too for the drawing for the canned good raffle. So bring in the canned goods. Also, we want to remind everybody, whoever brings in the most canned goods. The most canned goods.
Not rotten canned goods, by the way.
Not rotten, okay. They got to be updated.
Yeah,
canned goods will be a special guest on the Love Shack at the event. We will do an interview with whoever brings in the most canned goods. We'll interview them on the Love Shack about what they think about the event, their favorite wrestler. I know, Coin said you think it's going to be you.
It should be me.
That's what I figured.
Everybody's favorite wrestler.
But don't forget the canned food drive. Bring in canned goods for a good cause.
That's her. See, should tell you something about my favorite
wrestler.
Oh,
Lord have mercy. You don't surprise me one bit. And also, we're going to have a raffle for the The warden for the prison match also.
I should be the
whoever wins that will get a warden shirt and will be the warden, which should be the referee to open and shut the cage and declare the winner, which should be me. I'm undefeated in a singles match. Thank you very much. Of course, I haven't fought but three or four people. But okay, Charles, what do you think about the event?
I thought you will.
I think it's going to be good, Albert. I'll tell you what, man. You ought to. You do, how did you like your training there?
I'll tell you what. It would be good if I could have caught the twink, you know, but.
Well, Albert, I got something coming up here for you on your last one. You're going to really like it, Albert. It's going to be a... Oh, it's going to be a learning experience for you, Al, to say the least. But, yeah, we got a good show coming up, $5 seats. $5 model riches. Put the word out.
I forgot to say that.
Anywhere, so you get there early.
What?
Bring your food, your two canned goods, at least. Get your NFW merchandise, your Rob Conway, Flash Flanagan, and Doug Gilbert.
There you
and
go.
Albert, I even hear you might be giving something away. Is that right?
Oh, yeah, we've got a lot of NFW merchandise we'll be giving away. You know, shirts, all kinds of little knickknacks.
You know what we all put in there?
What's that?
Team Johnny Thongs.
Team Johnny Thongs. Oh, my gosh.
Johnny Richard panties, is that true?
Yes, sir. That on the front it says Johnny Richards was here. Nice, one size fits all, maybe.
All right, I know Albert had a slogan for you. Put Johnny's face in a happy place.
I like that better.
All right, Charles.
Still, Al. I'm telling
you. Well,
okay.
You said it, not me.
Now, like we said, you know, a raffle for the camp food drive, all kinds of merchandise. Bring in your canned goods with all kinds of merchandise. Flash, Doug, Rich, NFW merchandise. Rob Conway's got a bunch of merchandise also to bring in for it. I mean, you can't go wrong. You're going to win all kinds of stuff just to bring in canned goods. Plus, you get a chance to be on the Love Shack to have an interview.
And you get to see me wrestle.
And see Johnny Richards wrestle for the world title in the Trick or Treat match against Flash Flanagan. And tickets are only $5. You can't go wrong. Now, I'll tell you what. we've got a comment by your buddy, I guess, Robert Ames.
Hey, Robert.
Like the NFW Nation comment of the week. So we're going to listen to what Robert Ames has to say about our prison match. I'm
trying to hold my hand.
No.
Ian, just to give you a friendly reminder that the 27th is coming up. That's right, Halloween Madness, baby. And I just got one question for you is, why would you put yourself in a situation like this? Not only are you going to go against one of the top rising stars in NFW, Mr. Smart Mark Rivers, but in a match like this, they can strip away all your pride and dignity that you may have left? I mean, come on, what were you thinking? I mean, think about this. The loser of the match will be put inside a prison cell, which is only fitting for you since you and your cold general manager, Mr. Iron Man Rob Conway, run around like a bunch of modern-day criminals anyway. But, you know, regardless, you go ahead and do your little workout videos with Charming Charles, do your music montages, go running through the woods with your grandchildren, being chased by poodles. It doesn't matter, because in the end, Mr. Smart Rivers, he has told me personally that he has something up his sleeve. He has a little something that you don't, and that you should be worried. So, you go ahead and do your videos, drink your protein shakes, do what you have to do, because on the 27th, you will be locked inside that cage. That is all.
Oh, that was real cute. Hey, Charles, I tell you, I want to make a comment, but I'm going to let you comment on it first also before I lose control.
Okay, Al, I'm going to tell you this, buddy. Have I ever let you down?
No, you haven't.
We've been doing this hard, intense training, and it's going to pay off, Albert. I'll tell you what, I'll stick my neck on the line. This is how much I believe in my buddy Albert.
That's
Albert,
right.
If I lose, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll run around that ring in a diaper that night.
I'm definitely rooting for you now, Al.
Thank you. Don't worry, Charles. That never happened because, like I said, I haven't lost a singles match, and I'm not about to lose one against him.
About that, but I'll tell you what. If you lose, Albert, I'll leave NFW forever.
Don't do that. Don't do that. Boy, but if I win...
Albert, have some faith in yourself.
No, I tell you what, Charles. I ain't going to let you down. You've been helping me on my training, and also... You promised me a treat if I win, so, and don't make no comments, thank you. But I'm not going to let you down, my friend. You've done good for me, and I'll tell you what, that match, you know, there ain't going to be no ref there, but it's going to be a warden. I'm sure, you know, I could be just as mean as Smart Mark because I've been around the meanest. And I've been around the smartest.
You can get down early. I know you can. I've seen you back in the day, remember?
The prison match will be on, and it's going to be good. But I'll tell you what, I'm going to get off that subject before I lose my temper and go on with the rest of them. Like I said, we got a barbed wire match. That's okay. It's got ink pins in it now. Bobo Brazil Jr., which is the champion, going against Vic the Bruiser Lewis in a barbed wire match. I mean, that's Halloween Madness right there.
I tell you right now.
Oh, yeah, that's going to be crazy, Albert.
I did a 30-minute Iron Man steel cage match with Bobo, and Bobo didn't quit for 30 minutes. That's the night that me and him actually came off the top of the cage and threw the ring.
Yeah.
And a couple of weeks ago, I wrestled Vic the Bruiser in Tennessee, and he actually burned my eye. So, I mean, those two guys, and they hate each other. I didn't have nothing against either one, really. Them two hating each other like that, it's going to be good. It's going to be bloody.
It's going to be bloody. I'm just hope that they come out. Well, I would say come out unhurt, but there's no way you come out unhurt in that match. I mean, their arms, legs, eyes, I mean, no telling what's going to happen to them. I just hope that
I'm glad they're on last.
We got a first aid kit handy because we're probably going to need it. So, and a mop.
Come out that night. Bring some bread.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, now, the NFW World Championship. It's a trick-or-treat match. Johnny Richards, the challenger, will go up against NFW World Champion Flash Flanagan. And again, I'll let you explain the trick-or-treat match.
You got four boxes around the ring. Three of the boxes will have a weapon in there. One box will have an object in it, like maybe you.
Me.
Could be in there. Or Jimmy, the camera guy.
Jimmy, and Dan. It's my videographer now.
So the fact of the matter is, Flash Flanagan, you know, you picked this match. I've seen you do this match in Puerto Rico. I've seen you do this match over in OVW and a couple other places. And the fact of the matter is this, is Flash, I don't care what you did in Puerto Rico. I don't care what you did in OVW. I don't care what you did in WWE. I don't care what you did in USWA. I don't care what you did in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. I don't care what you did, period. The fact of the matter is this, you have what is mine. And the only reason that you've had that as long as you have is because I have allowed you to hold that for me. On the 27th, everything will be complete.
I tell you what, you said Flash picked this match, but it's a trick-or-treat match, and I tell you what, your attitude and the way you've acted here, I would say lately, but it's always been kind of deranged. I tell you what, I don't know if it favors more of you than us, Flash. Hey, Charles, that match, what do you think about the trick-or-treat match?
It's going to be crazy. It's going to be a good one. You know, the thing is, Albert, you don't know what's in that box. I don't know what's in that box. Johnny Richards don't know what's in that box. And Brian don't know what's in that box.
Maybe it's wrong.
It could be something in there that's crazy to hurt one another, or it might be something to scare the heck out of both of them. You never know. That's why it's a trick-or-treat.
I know. And again, NFW World title, trick-or-treat match, NFW World Champion Flash Flanagan up against Johnny Richards.
You know what would be cool if it'd be in one of those boxes?
What's that?
Rats.
Rats, oh my gosh. At least you didn't say thongs.
Lots of rats.
Rats.
Oh, there's a bunch of them there. We just got to get them in the box.
Bring over Smart.
I got some cheese, Charles.
Smart Mark.
Yeah, they like rats.
Okay, now another match. Mr. Wrestling, Nick Densmore, which is a great scientific wrestler. He acts like sometimes he's off the wall, but I'll tell you what, you can't turn your back on him. He's going to be teamed up with Gator McCallister.
Team, Albert.
What's that, sir?
He's in a tag match with Gator.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, Nick Densmore, Mr. Wrestling, and Gator McCallister going up against SOL. I tell you what, SOL, we know how crazy and mad they can be, but, you know, you got Nick Densmore and Gator, a tag team, and, I mean, you got a guy who's tall, who's big, who's mean, and a guy who's strong, and a guy who's really smart and scientific. I mean, it's going to be a great match.
Gator McCallister, NFW's first ever tri-state champion. Matter of fact,
Nick Gator McCallister, yeah.
Nick Densmore, former WWE tag team champion. He's last count I know, a 10-time OVW World Heavyweight Champion. So, I mean, you got a heck of a team right there.
It's going to be great.
SOL, Scotty Wolf, former NFW World Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, mister, are you ready for a fight? Scotty Wolf.
Former NFW World Champion. Anthony Blaze will be there. He's held numerous titles.
Hardcore
titles, you know, tag titles.
Both of them are pretty good hardcore guys too. They don't mind bleeding either. I mean, the more they bleed, the happier they are, I think. But again, they're SOL going against Mr. Ass and Nick Densmore and Gator McCallister. That's, you know, like I said, that's another Halloween Madness match. I mean, like for $5, you can't go wrong. I mean, every match is like a main event.
It's almost like 50 cents a match.
I mean, you can't even get a movie that cheap. You can't even rent a movie that cheap.
You can't get a rat that cheap.
Now, of course, the co-GM, Iron Man Rob Conway, will be there.
Screw Rob Conway.
You know, he said he's got some extras for the Nation and Johnny Richards.
My heart is so real.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Richard Bullock!
Again, we got the Prism match, and I also want to make that... Oh, give me a break. That's okay. That's why
Since Rob Conway's been a new British wrestler, that's all he's done is cry.
I don't get title shot.
You can say what you want. Let's see how.
Oh, my hair is too long.
I'm sure he's got something to say to you, too. You know?
Wow. Johnny Richards beat me again. Wow.
Here we go.
You know what? Rob Conway, if you're out there listening, which I know you are, if you get cleared by your doctors, I don't care when it is, I want to be your first match back.
Hey, Charles.
Yes, sir, Albert.
We're going to get a hold of the Iron Man and see, maybe he can watch. Well, he'll watch this, and hopefully we can get his comments before the event and put it on here. What do you think?
I think that's possible, Albert. Real possible.
I hope he breaks his other arm.
I will try it again. Oh, also, another match has been added. Rudy Boy Gonzalez.
Yes, sir.
Alex Rain.
No.
And I tell you what, he's tough too. Going up against the Texas Tornadoes.
That's gonna be a hell of a match.
What do you think, Charles?
You know, that'll be good.
I mean,
Rudy Boy, the trainer of former World Heavyweight Champion Daniel Bryan.
That's right. I just showed you. He knows. He knows. He's got what it takes to be a winner. You know, Alex Rain. I've heard a lot about him too.
And he's a product of Rudy Boy.
Product of Rudy Boy going up against Texas Tornadoes. You can't, you know, Texas Tornadoes are tough.
They're having a tough so, they came you know. In and they beat your kid.
Oh. That's okay. That's okay. He's tough too. He'll be back.
At least he don't cry like
that. Also, we got guys coming in. T Boat will be there. Have you heard from him last week? He don't care who he faces. He says whoever he faces is going to win. He guaranteed victory, but that's T Boat for you.
He's a jerk.
Yeah, I ain't going to say that. Dyron Flynn, which is one man workhorse.
Dyron Flynn.
He is tough.
Guys on independent.
He's kind of like Bill Dundee kind of type. You know, he's one of the toughest. I mean, he's not small, but for a guy his size, he's, you know, he makes up his size and strength and his moves, agility, his smartness. I mean, he's tough. I mean, you know, you can't take him for granted because I tell you what, he's good. He's about as tough as the big guys are. I mean, he's tough for some of the big guys. I mean, he's great.
He's a future.
I mean, he's a very smart wrestler, very talented wrestler, and he's got a lot going for him.
No match for getting. Dangerous Doug Gilbert and Nick Giggy.
Yeah. That's right. Dangerous Doug Gilbert versus Nick Giggy. I can't forget that. You got a high flyer, quick Nick Giggy going against to come at you, the ball back Doug Gilbert. Ooh, Charles, what do you think?
I think that's going to be a good match, Albert. I'm thinking about something too just right now. You ain't going to lose that prison match, Al. You know what happens to you if you go to prison, don't you?
Oh, do hard time, I know that.
Yeah, you better buy you some boxer shorts if you lose.
And don't drop.
Anyway, that's beside
me. I'm not going to say
don't. No, that's going to be a real good match. I'm looking forward to it. You got the young scientific math technician, and you got the old damn Memphis baller right there.
There you go.
Doug Gilbert, sneaker and a snake, man. He get down and get dirty.
You got one of the guys who helped build wrestling in Evansville, Indiana.
That's
the
right.
Future of this business.
Tommy Gilbert's a living legend. I mean, you know, he comes from a great background, a great family background, and
almost as good as my family.
Almost as good. Well, I love Mama Rich. I will say that Mama Rich is an angel. She is the sweetheart in FW. And like I said, Dangerous Doug Gilbert going against Nick Iggy. I tell you what, you know, Nick's got his work cut out for him.
I'll show you something real fast.
Don't you dare!
I want to show you something real fast. Look.
Camera
guy. See that? That's Dangerous Doug Gilbert right there.
Dangerous Doug Gilbert.
I'm rooting for you, DG.
He's the man. He's tough. He's tough.
Doug Gilbert's great.
He's tough. Like I said, he's going up against Nick Iggy. I tell you what, I got a lot of confidence in Nick Iggy. He's tough too, but he's got his work cut out for him going against Dangerous one.
Nick Iggy proved himself at the last show.
Yeah, he sure did. He sure did. Again, we got, like I said, Tebow, Dyron Flynn. We got Chad Stallings, Tempest, Bishop, Johnny Whiplash, much more. Like I said, all tickets are just $5. Bring in King Good to help out Hope Central and be entered to a drawing for free tickets, prizes, merchandise, Rob Conway merchandise, all kinds of Rob Conway merchandise, Doug Gilbert merchandise, Flash Lane merchandise, Rich merchandise, NFW merchandise, two tickets to next show, and plus the chance to have you be an interview on the Love Shack also. Speaking of merchandise, next week, hopefully, The NFW Hats will be here, which will be on the Love Shack, and Team Johnny LTD Tour.
Yes.
T-shirts will be here.
Samantha's going to totally be rocking the shit out of that shirt.
I bet. So we got some cool merchandise coming in. Cool merchandise for sale. Raffle tickets. Canned Good Drive for the raffle. To win the raffle. The raffle for the Warden. All these matches, like I said, we got, you know, Daniels, Doug Gilbert, Nick Iggy. We got Mr. Rice, Nick Dinsmore, and Gator McCausland going against SOL. We've got the NFW World Champion match, Trick or Treat match. Flash Flame going with Johnny Richards. We got the Barbed Wire match, Bubba Brazil Jr., Victor Bruce Lewis. We got the Prison match, Big Al against Mark Rivers, which is going to lose. And like I said, bell time 7:30, 5820 Medical Drive here in Evansville, Indiana, October 27th. New Focus Wrestling presents Halloween Madness. Whew! I'll tell you what, before we spread love, I'm sure you've got something you want to say. So I'm going to let you have the mic. Whatever you want to say, whatever you want to get off your chest, you know, you're more than welcome.
I still get emails about the text, and I get text every day, at least. And the more of these texts I get, the more I kind of see the light. I've been in this business for 12 years, and I've kind of came to a great conclusion. And Flash Flanagan, this goes to you and a lot of people out there. So, camera guy, I need you to zoom in here. I got a little show and tell here.
Zoom it in.
You see that okay? You see what that says on there? You're getting there good, son. You're in there good. The fact of the matter is over 12 years, I never needed a revolution. Over all that time, can you see this one real good? I want to make sure you see the name on that one. You got that? I never needed a 19-year-old glorified cheerleader.
Now zoom out.
Why don't you zoom out a little bit? Zoom out just a little bit. Can you see both of us okay? Good. I never needed a caretaker. The fact of the matter is this. The only thing I ever needed was Team Johnny. And on October 27th, the world will see, and Flash Flanagan will be the first one to feel exactly why I am the career killer. I am the lady thriller. I am the show stealer, the product of you people, the son of sin, the draw, the only man that truly matters, and your next NFW World Heavyweight Champion. I am Johnny fucking Richards.
Charles.
Yo.
Go ahead and spread the love. We're done.
Y'all had Albert?
Yeah, we're done.
Okay, Albert. You sure you're okay?
Yeah.
All right, NFW Nation, just remember one thing. Don't fight amongst yourselves. Leave the fighting us. All you have to do is spread the love.